Welcome to CIC. That's what we call it in the day. It was called Combat Information is the real name. And this is where all the data, the battle data came in, was collected, disseminated, and acted on. All that was done right here. The tactical action officer ran the show. He sat right here. We called him the TAO. So everybody in these rooms was working for this guy right here. He's running the whole show. And the captain is not here. You'll notice the captain is not here. He's up on the bridge. So he had a big responsibility, this man right here, controlling the operation here. Let's talk a little bit about what he's dealing with. He's defending the ship. That's his principal role. Offensive operations were done elsewhere. So this, the information that he has available, that's what we're worried about today. We have radars. So the Midway has radars. You see the radar sweep right here. And all the escort ships around the Midway have radars. So that information is collected in here. And I'm going to show you a little bit how that's put into the network. We also have a radar plane that he controls. That's out in the direction of the enemy. It could be as much as 100 miles, maybe even further. And so what is radar anyway? Well, radar is very simple. It's all it is an electronic pulse that's sent out. It bounces off an aircraft and comes back to ship. That's how we find out where aircraft are. The next thing I want to talk about is IFF, identification, friend or foe. It's another piece of equipment. Identification, friend or foe. So what does that mean? We're trying to find out who those aircraft are. The bad guys are not going to respond to us. So what we're finding out is the good guys, really. All of that information and from all our ships and other ships in the task force is coming in to a network. And everybody in this room is looking at a little snapshot of that network. We've seen so far that security of our information was a critical component. When you look around this room, you won't see a lot of classified material laying around. It's being used and then locked up. So one of my favorite things in here was right here, our radio telephones. And this is how we talk to other ships. And this is pretty unique. And this is an encrypted phone. We call that red or covered phone. A lot of people would use the term scrambler or scrambled and describe that conversation. I really love using this particular piece of equipment because I didn't have to use a lot of codes and funny talk. I could just talk plainly and it would take care of it for scrambling for me. I want to mention call signs. Call signs on this board right over here. So we used call signs so we didn't have to use our name. We didn't say Midway. We used a call sign, and the call sign for the Midway was schoolboy. So I can remember back in the day using your call signs like this. You would say, schoolboy, this is Gold Eagle. That's how a conversation would go. And sometimes we even use, if we wanted to change our call signs every day, we would use a call sign like Alpha Bravo November X-ray is an example of a four-letter call sign that we would use. The last thing I want to talk about is electronic warfare, and that's in the room behind me. And electronic warfare was a way to get early detection of the enemy. Because what we're doing is listening or looking for the characteristics or the electronic fingerprints of the radars that the enemy may be using against us. So if we know those characteristics, then we can identify where the country they was manufactured, what kind of aircraft, what kind of ship it came from. So this was critical information for us. That information would then go back into the network, which we discussed early. We do really the same things today that you just saw. It just looks a lot cooler. You have flat panel displays, more LED lights. The network has more information. It's faster and more secure, but conceptually, it's identical to what you just saw today. It just looks cooler. Thanks for visiting the Midway.